the stimulation station.
Alex Davidson from Newcastle upon Tyne, Kevin Finnan from Dublin, Stephen Nixon from Hartlepool, Cliff Fairley from Petersfield in Hampshire, Gwen Wilson from Chorley in Lancashire, Mark Coleman from Glasgow, Elford Evans-Jones from Cambridge, David Parker from Mansfield in Nottinghamshire, Bill Brush from Hartford, Stanley Taylor from Huddersfield, Ken Goodhue from Carlin, Wiltshire, Eunice Shaw from Wallsend in Tyne and Wear, Ray Emerson from Herne Bay in Kent, Alan Longman from Wickham in Hampshire, and Gloucester Yeo from Saltash in Cornwall are all here to play 15 to 1. Presented by William G. Stewart.
Thank you. Hello. Our previous winner today is Mark Coleman from Glasgow. Welcome back, Mark. Winning scores above 170 are not easy to come by, so most of the names on the finals board, there it is, will be hoping that they can hang on for the next 11 games. None more so than John Beasley. Let's see if today's going to make any change. Off we go. And we begin with Alex Davidson from Newcastle upon Tyne. Alex, television superstars. Which Australian housewife superstar created by Barry Humphries comes from Moonee Ponds in Victoria? Dame Edna Everidge. Yeah. Kevin, please, Shakespeare. In which Shakespeare play do three characters known as the Weird Sisters appear?
Macbeth.
Stephen, please. Swing Bridge, High Level Bridge and Queen Elizabeth II Bridge are well-known landmarks in which British city?
Newcastle.
That's the question Alex wanted. Cliff, please. British political parties. The headquarters of which political party are at 4 Cowley Street in London?
The Liberal Party.
There is no Liberal Party, it's the Liberal Democrats. And Gwen, please. Which member of the royal family, the son of the Duke of Kent, recently forfeited his place as 25th in line to the throne when he converted to the Roman Catholic faith this year?
Don't know.
Lord Nicholas Windsor. Mark, please. Which English county is this? Its symbol is a rampant white horse, its motto is Invicta, meaning the unconquered, and it is traditionally known as the Garden of England.
Kent.
And Elved. Science. Which science, whose name derives from the Greek for work, is the study of the relationships between workers and their environment?
Operational.
Ergonomics. David, please. Business and Commerce. Which major utility company, part of the Centrica Group, scrapped standing charges last year and replaced them with a pay-for-what-you-use system?
BT.
British Gas. Bill, please. The game of snooker. In a frame of snooker, unless one player concedes the frame, how many balls are left on the table at the end of the frame?
Seven.
One, the white ball. Stanley, please. History of musicals. Blitz, Twang, Oliver. The composer, please.
Lyricist. Lionel Bart.
Yes, Lionel Bart. And Ken, Monopoly. What's the most expensive property on the standard London Monopoly board?
Park Lane Hotel.
Mayfair, at £400. Eunice, classical music. Violin concertos known as Il Sospetto, La Tempesta di Mari and Il Favorito. Works by which Italian composer?
Brooke.
Vivaldi. Ray, please. Botany. Vanilla is a pod or bean of which family of flowering plants?
Sorry.
Orchids. Alan, rock and roll. Maybelline, Johnny B. Goode and Roll Over Beethoven. Hit songs for which rock and roll legend?
Bill Haley.
Chuck Berry. Gloucester, please. London. The name of which well-known London thoroughfare is derived from an ancient game resembling croquet?
Sorry.
Pall Mall. And quotations, Alex. Of which British field marshal in the Second World War did Winston Churchill reputedly say, in defeat unbeatable, in victory unbearable?
Montgomery.
And Kevin, please. In which branch of alternative medicine are there points on the body called Fourth Gutter, the Palace of Weariness and the Gate of Hope?
Acupuncture.
Stephen, please. Nicknames. What famous sobriquet coined by Rudyard Kipling connected Queen Victoria after the death of Prince Albert with one of her residences?
The Widow of Windsor.
Yes, you just got it out. Or the Widow at Windsor, either would have done. Cliff, please. Musicals and poetry. Mr. Mistopheles, Griddlebone and Mungo Jerry are characters from the musical Cats. Their original creator, please.
Andrew Lloyd Webber.
T.S. Eliot. Gwen, please. Medicine. Gingivitis is inflammation of which parts of the body?
The gums.
And Mark, Charles Dickens. Who at the end of the novel Hard Times lives into old age, quote, making his facts and figures subservient to faith, hope and charity?
Gradgrind.
Yes, Thomas Gradgrind. And Elvid, which city in the USA has a Spanish name meaning the meadows? Las Vegas. David, please. What are the canaries in Norwich, the owls in Sheffield and the foxes in Leicester?
Football team nicknames.
And Bill? Geography. England's four highest mountain peaks, all over 900 metres high, are all in which county?
Derbyshire.
Cumbria. Stanley, please. Independent television. Which independent television production company, much in the news recently, makes Who Wants to Be a Millionaire for ITV?
Cedar Holdings.
Celador. Ken, please. Royal firsts. Who in 1932 was the first British monarch to make a Christmas Day broadcast?
George V.
And Eunice, please. Science, the SI unit of frequency, is named after which 19th century German physicist?
Oh.
Hertz. Ray, please. The New Testament, the Gospel of St. Luke. What was the name of the aged Jew who took the infant Jesus in his arms in the temple at Jerusalem?
No.
Simeon. Alan, please. The average level of the surface of the sea is known as MSL. What does MSL stand for in that context?
Minimum sea level.
Mean sea level. Mean meaning average. And Gloucester, please. Plant diseases. The fungus Sertocystis ulmi was responsible for the loss of millions of trees in Britain in the 1970s. By what name is it more commonly known?
Dutch elm disease.
It is indeed. Six down, nine to go, and those six must leave us now. And Laura, please.
And those eliminated are Cliff Fairley, Elvid Evans-Jones, Bill Brush, Eunice Shaw, Ray Emerson and Alan Longman. And the remaining nine contestants, three, still have their three lives intact.
We start round two with Alex at number one, first correct answer, and we can start nominating. And Alex, we start with business and commerce. Which company, best known for its frozen foods, became the first British national food retailer to ban GM ingredients in its own brand products?
Iceland.
And a number, please?
15.
The arts, please, Gloucester. With which art form were the German F.W. Murnau, the Frenchman Jean Renoir, and the Briton Sir Michael Boulton leading names?
Impressionism.
Cinema. Again, please.
11.
And Ken, please. Foreign words and phrases. Which French word meaning relaxation is often used to describe the easing of strained relations, especially between states or nations?
Laissez-faire.
Détente. Again, please, Alex.
10.
And Stanley, please. Pop groups. Which pop group of the late 1970s and early 80s had hit singles about not liking Mondays and being caught in a rat trap?
Oasis.
The Boomtown Rats, Bob Geldof's group. Again, please.
8.
And David, please. Europe. After the Vatican, and with an area of under 2 square kilometres, which European principality is the smallest independent state in the world?
Monaco.
And a number, please, David.
Number 15.
And Gloucester, the name, please, of the Secretary-General of the United Nations?
Afan?
No. Kofi Annan. Again, please, David.
Number 11, please.
Cookery, Ken. The famous Mrs. Beaton, who wrote the famous cookery book. What was her first name?
Cecilia.
Isabella. Again, David.
Number 10, please.
And China, Stanley. What's the name of the large square in Beijing in which the Great Hall of the People stands?
Tiananmen Square.
Yes, Tiananmen Square. Onwards, please.
Number 1.
And Alex, please. The New Testament. What single word is commonly used to describe the apostolic letters of the saints Paul, Peter, James, Jude and John collectively?
Peace.
Epistles. Again, please. Stanley?
Number 3.
And Stephen, please. History of medicine. Which 16th, 17th century English physician discovered the mechanism of blood circulation?
Lister.
William Harvey. Again, please, Stanley.
Number six.
Sport, Mark. The Heineken Cup, the Tetley's Bitter Cup and the Bowring Bowl are trophies competed for in which sport?
Rugby union.
Yes, the number please, Mark.
Number five.
Gilbert and Sullivan, Gwen. In which Gilbert and Sullivan operetta does a girl engaged to a law enforcement officer fall in love with a musician who is really the son of an emperor?
Mikado.
And a number please, Gwen.
Number three.
And Stephen, the 1960s, Sir Alec Douglas Hume became Prime Minister. Doctor Who first appeared on our television screens. The great train robbery took place. Which year in the 1960s?
63.
And a number, Stephen?
10, please.
Food and drink, Stanley. Absolut and Stolichnaya are leading brand names associated with what?
D.
Vodka. Again, please, Stephen.
Number two.
And Kevin, please. In which county are the towns of Maidenhead, Slough and Reading?
Sussex.
Berkshire. Again, please, Stephen.
Number one.
Fruit, Alex. Which fruit, a hybrid of the grapefruit and tangerine, has a name that sounds as if it is particularly unattractive to look at?
Ugly.
And onwards, please.
Number six.
Film quotations, Mark. Cancel the kitchen scraps for lepers and orphans. No more merciful beheadings and call off Christmas. Words spoken by Alan Rickman as the Sheriff of Nottingham in which 1990s film?
Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves.
That's it. That was the last bit I wanted. Onwards, please.
Number eight.
English law, please, David. What title is held by the lawyer who, under the direction of the Attorney General, gives legal advice to the courts on difficult or disputed legal problems involving divorce?
Lord Advocate.
The Queen's Proctor. Again, please, Mark.
Number five.
The USA, Gwen. Baton Rouge, the state capital of Louisiana, stands on which river? The Mississippi. Again, please.
Number three.
And Stephen, industry. A statutory corporation established in 1954. What is abbreviated as the UKAEA? UKAEA.
No idea.
The United Kingdom Atomic Energy Authority. Again, please, Mark.
Number one.
And Alex, please. Sport again. Linebacker, wide receiver, tight end and running back are field positions in which sport?
American football.
Number, please.
Two.
Literary quotations, Kevin. War is peace, freedom is slavery, ignorance is strength. From which novel by George Orwell does that slogan come?
1984.
And number, Kevin.
Number eight, please.
Science, please, David. The synthesized chemical element with the atomic number 98 is named after which western state of the USA where it was first made?
California.
Yes, it's Californium.
Number one, please.
And Alex, please. Food and drink. What Italian word, literally meaning before the meal, refers to food served as appetizers before the meal proper begins? Antipasto. Again, please, David.
Number three, please.
And Stephen, please. Classic television. Jeff Tracy and his five sons run the secret organisation International Rescue from a remote Pacific island. Which popular puppet series first shown in the 1960s?
Thunderbirds.
And the number, Stephen?
Five.
The Bible and Genesis, Gwen. Which of the 12 sons of Jacob was sold as a slave into the household of the Egyptian captain Potiphar?
Joseph.
And a number, please, Gwen?
Two.
Kevin, which motorway links London to Winchester?
The A40.
The M3. Again, please.
Number six.
And Mark, please. Zoology. Which creature has species called fire-bellied, spadefoot and midwife?
A lizard.
On the right track, toads. Again, please, Gwen.
Number two.
Fiction and fashion, Kevin. Which novel by George du Maurier inspired a vogue for a type of felt hat named after the book's heroine?
Panama.
Trilby. Again, please, Gwen.
Number three.
And Stephen, please. Art and famous paintings. Which Spanish artist painted the two famous pictures, the Naked Maya and the Clothed Maya?
El Greco.
Goya. And there you are, 12 down, 3 to go, and after the break, Gwen Wilson from Chorley in Lancashire, Mark Coleman from Glasgow, and David Parker from Mansfield in Nottinghamshire will be here for the final. I hope you'll be here with us.
future's bright, the future's orange.
Traditional Leslie.
Modern Leo.
Hurry down to the Homebase Christmas Bonanza for an extra 20% off decorations and all artificial trees.
Merry Christmas, Leslie.
This Friday till Monday.
The three surviving contestants in today's 15-1 final are Gwen Wilson, a housewife from Chorley in Lancashire. She likes to spend time with her three grandchildren, and she also enjoys watching quizzes and all kinds of sport. Mark Coleman, an actor and drama teacher from Glasgow. He has just been in a production of Hamlet at the Ramsthorne Theatre in Glasgow, and he teaches at the Airnock High School. His hobbies include reading, taking part in pub quizzes, and building a doll's house. And David Parker, a factory operative from Mansfield in Nottinghamshire. He works for a confectionery manufacturer, and as well as enjoying reading, he also belongs to the Mansfield Quiz League.
Thank you. Welcome back. Before we start, if you fancy a go at 15-1, and if we have time, I'll give you the addresses at the end of the programme. Gwen, Mark and David, put your fingers on the buzzers. Any winning score would be OK, of course. A winning score above 172 would be enough for a place on the finals board. Anything above 200 at this stage of the series ought to be enough for a place in the grand final. And anything above 292 would win for you our finals board trophy. If you're happy with all of that, here we go. Political terms. What two-word expression, partly implying medical expertise, is used to... Mark?
Spin doctor.
Indeed. Will you please look at this, please, and tell me. This is part of the logo of a registered charity that seeks to raise awareness of mental illness and to provide care and support to anyone concerned about mental illness. Which charity? And Gwen?
Sane.
Yes, it is Sane. If you look carefully, you can make out the letters S-A-N-E. It stood originally for Schizophrenia, a National Emergency. And there's the full logo. Here we go. Geometry. What name is given to the solid figure that has 12 edges, all of equal length and at right angles to each other? Mark?
Cube.
On we go, please. What connects these places with Henry VIII? Peterborough Cathedral, Windsor Castle... Mark?
Where he was married.
I was going to go on with Windsor Castle, Westminster Abbey, Sudley Castle in Gloucester and two in the Chapel of St Peter at Vincula in the Tower of London, the graves of his wives. And on we go. Classic television, a famous line from Basil Fawlty, said of Manuel, I'm so sorry, he's from...
Barcelona.
Yes, indeed. And on we go, please. Politics and sport. Whose childhood ambition, which dwarfed even his dream of becoming Prime Minister, was fulfilled earlier this year when he was elected to the MCC committee? Gwen?
James
John Major. And on we go, please. Still sport and cricket. Two countries on the continent of Africa play official test cricket. South Africa?
Zimbabwe.
Indeed, David. On we go. Rhyming slang and Dickens. What does it mean if a Cockney is said to be up before the Barnaby Rudge? Mark?
Up before the judge.
Yes, in fact, in court. And three correct answers. Question or nominate?
Nominate David.
David, the House of Lords. What term describes independent members of the House of Lords who do not take a party whip?
Backbenchers.
Crossbenchers. Mark, question or nominate?
Nominate Gwen.
Gwen, musical instruments. Which musical instrument, consisting of a wooden sound box with strings of varying thicknesses, is named after the Greek god of the wind?
Harp.
I need more than that.
Harpsichord.
No. Aeolian harp. And again, please?
David.
And David, please, landmarks. Which two large countries are linked near a famous cataract by a steel arch bridge called Rainbow Bridge?
Oh, Niagara Falls.
That wasn't the question. Which two countries?
Oh,
the USA and Canada. Again, please, Mark.
Gwen.
And Gwen, please. Pop music. She was one of the lonely people in the Lennon and McCartney song named after her. Who? Eleanor Rigby. You have to lead us. And I'm back with you again, Mark. Question or nominate?
Nominate David.
David, science. Chlorine, bromine and iodine belong to which group of elements? The halogens. Now, we've stood together like this before. Mark, last time, what was your winning score?
81.
81. Well, you've got 32 now, two lives left, and there are 27 questions. Let's see, firstly, if you can beat the 81, and then the 172, and then maybe up to 200 for a place in the grand final. Famous women. Best known for her services in the Crimean War, she was in 1907 the first woman to be awarded the Order of Merit. Who?
Florence Nightingale.
English historians. The English chronicler, whose major work, Historia Regum Britanniae, was a main source for medieval European literature, was known as Geoffrey of where?
Monmouth.
Yes, indeed. English counties. The Cotswolds lie mainly in which county?
Derbyshire.
Gloucestershire. What word, derived from the Greek for having feet opposite, is given to a place that is diametrically opposite to another, especially Australasia, as the region on the opposite side of the Earth to Europe?
Antipodean.
Or Antipodes, either, yeah. Will you please look at this and tell me, on the subject of Antipodeans, the surname, please, of these Australian cricketing twins? Surname?
Smith.
Stephen Mark Waugh. The score doesn't really matter. You're a winner. I always tell people it's better to win 1-0 than to lose 5-4. Mm. Anyway, there you are, Mark. 62, your winning score. No place on the finals board, but a chance to come and join us again for a third time.
Thank you.
Yes? Well done. There you go. Thank you. Before we go, and as we have a bit of time, here's something interesting. You will know that I often get letters on pronunciation on 15 to 1. For example, I say medicine, but it can be medicine. I say seamstress, and it can be semstress. One letter, regular viewers will recall, put me straight on why one American president of the earlier 20th century was Teddy Roosevelt, and why Franklin D. was Roosevelt. Well, I had a letter a little while ago that I put to one side, but eventually got round to. And Mr. David Lyon from Hove wrote pointing out what he called a common mistake in the pronunciation of the name of the French artist and sculptor Degas. This is the spelling, D-E-G-A-S. He pointed out that, as there is no acute accent over the E, it shouldn't be Degas, but Degas. I warmed to Mr. Lyon because he added, "You are usually so careful with your pronunciation." Well, that's because we do have a researcher on 15 to 1 whose job it is to look after pronunciation. So we looked into it, and sure enough, the major art galleries, Tate Britain, Tate Modern, and the National Gallery all confirmed that Mr. Lyon is right, though all added that, as everyone knows the artist as Degas, it might be difficult to persuade people to change to Degas. We then rang the Académie Française in Paris, the definitive source for the French language, and sure enough, they confirmed that it is Degas. I don't think this is going to change things, but at least on 15 to 1 in the future, he will be Degas. Though it has to be said that the composer Henry Purcell was once commonly called Purcell, and the poet Southey more often called Southey. I'm grateful to you, Mr. Lyon, for recognising that quiz programmes needn't always be about dumbing down. And finally, before we go, here are the addresses I promised. 15 to 1, P.O. Box 273, London W1A6EH, postcards only, please, or by email to 15to1@channel4.com. That's it. We'll be back tomorrow. See you then.
Next up, Richard's a chump looking for a champ in Countdown on 4.